Hello students, welcome back to the online classes. We are learning the unit arithmetic progression. Now we are solving the problems based on the concept of the sum of n terms of the AP. The sum of n terms of the given AP is given by the formulas Sn equals n divided by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. The another form of the Sn formula is that sum formula is Sn equals n divided by 2 into a plus an, where the nth term is an. Now the sum of n positive integers of the given AP is given by the formula Sn equals n times n plus 1 divided by 2. For n positive integers, the sum of n positive integers is given by the formula Sn equals n times n plus 1 divided by 2. Now we'll continue with the exercise. In an AP given a equals 5, d equals 3, an equals 50, we should find out the value of n and Sn. Now I'll write down the given data, that is a equals 5, d equals 3, then an equals 50. I should find out n equals question mark, then Sn equals question mark. Now by using the nth term formula, that is an equals a plus n minus 1 into d, using this formula I'll find out the value of n. Now substitute the value of an, that is 50, which is equal to what is the value of a, that is 5, plus n minus 1 as it is, into value of d is 3. Now shift plus 5 to LHS, it becomes 50 minus 5, which is equal to remaining term is n minus 1 into 3. Now 50 minus 5 is 45, n minus 1 into 3. Now I'll write it as 45 divided by 3, which is equal to n minus 1. Now 3 times 1 is 3, then 3 times 15 is 45. You get n minus 1 equals 50. Now shift minus 1 to LHS, it becomes plus 1. Therefore, n equals 15 plus 1, which is equal to 16. Therefore, the value of n is 16. Now I should find out Sn. N becomes 16 now. Now by using the formula Sn equals n divided by 2 into a plus an, I can use the identity Sn equals 2a plus n minus 1 into d. The simpler is Sn equals n divided by 2 times a plus an, since I have the value of the last term an. Therefore Sn equals n divided by 2 into a plus an. Now substitute the value of all these variables. Sn equals, that is S, 16 equals 16 divided by 2 into what is the value of A, that is 5, plus the last term An is 50. S 16 equals 16 divided by 2, that is 2 times 1 is 2, then 2 times 8 is 16, therefore 8 times 50 plus 5 is 55. Now S 16 is 8 times 55, that is S 16 equals 8 times 55 is 440. Therefore the sum of 16 terms is 440. S 16 equals 440. Now moving to next question. A equals 7, A 13 equals 35. We should find out the value of D and S 13. I'll write down the given data. Given A equals 7, then A 13 equals 35, that is 13 term equals 35. Now N equals 13. Now I should find out the value of D and S 13. Again by using the nth term formula of an AP, I'll find out the value of D. That is using the nth term formula, that is AN equals A plus N minus 1 into D. AN equals A plus N minus 1 into D. Now substitute all the values in nth term formula, that is N equals 13, that is A 13 equals A 7 plus n minus 1, that is 13 minus 1 into d as it is, since we should find out. Now a 13 is 35. Now shift plus 1 is 7 to LHS, it becomes minus 7, which is equal to 13 minus 1 is 12 times d. Now 35 minus 7 we get 28, which is equal to 12 times d. Now d equals 28 divided by 12. 4 times 3 is 12, 4 times 7 is 28. We get d as what? 7 divided by 3. D equals what? 7 divided by 3. Now again by using the sum formula, it is Sn equals n divided by 2 into a plus an, will find out the sum of 13 terms, that is S13. Therefore Sn equals n divided by 2 into a plus an. Now what is the value of n? That is 13. S13 equals 13 divided by 2. What is the value of a? Substitute it, that is 7 plus the last term an is 13 term, that is 35. Now we get S13 equals 13 divided by 2. 7 plus 35 is 42. Now divide 42 divided by 2. 2 times 1 is 2. 2 times 21 is 42. Now we get S13 equals 13 times 21, which is equal to 273. The sum of 13 terms is 273. We got D as 7 by 3 and S13 as 273. Now moving to next question. Given the 12th term A12 equals 37, D equals 3, we should find out the value of A and S12. Write on the given data, that is given A12, that is 12th term equals 37, D equals 3, now N equals 12, then we should find out A and S12. Now using nth term formula, that is an equals a plus n minus 1 into d, by using this we'll find out the value of a, that is first term. Now the last term an is what? That is 12th term, that is 37. An equals 37, which is equal to a as it is a plus, what is the value of n? That is 12 minus 1 into 3. The value of d is 3. Now 37 equals a plus 12 minus 1 is 11 into 3. Now 37 equals a plus 11 times 3 is 33. Now shift plus 33 to LHS, it becomes minus 33. Therefore a equals 37 minus 33. Therefore a equals 37 minus 33 is 4. We get first term as 4. Now again using the Sn formula, Sn equals n divided by 2 into a plus an, will find out sum of 12 terms. Sn equals n divided by 2 times a plus an. Now S12 equals 12 divided by 2. What is the value of a? That is 4 plus an, that is last term a12 equals 37. Now 12 times divided by 2 is 6. We get S12 equals 6 times 4 plus 37 is 41. Now we get S12 equals 6 times 41, that is equal to 246. The sum of 12 terms is 246. Now we'll move to the next question. Given the third term A3 equals 15 and the sum of 10 terms S10 equals 125, we should find out the value of D and 10th term. Now we have got A3 equals 15, that is third term A3 equals 15. Now I'll express A3 as A plus 2D by using general form. A3 can be written as a plus 2d. The third term can be written as a plus 2d by using general form of AP. Now given S10 equals 125, that is 125. Now I'll convert S10 in terms of sum formula, that is n divided by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d, which is equal to 125. Now, substitute the value of n, that is 10 divided by 2 becomes 5 times 2a plus 10 minus 1 is 9, that is it becomes 90, which is equal to 125. Now cancelling on both sides, that is LHS and RHS, 5 times 1 is 5, 5 times 25 is 125, we get 2a plus 9d, which is equal to 25, taking this as equation 2. Now we have got two equations in terms of the variable a and d. We should solve this to get the value of a and d. Now I'll eliminate the variable a by making the coefficients same, that is I'll multiply equation 1 by 2. It becomes multiply equation 1 by 2, 2 times a is 2a, 2 times 2d is 4d, 2 times 15 is 30. Now if you observe equation 2 and 3, the variable a as coefficient same, that is 2 and 2. Now what I'll do, I'll do equation 2 minus equation 3, subtract equation 3 from equation 2, that is equation 2 minus equation 3, we get 2a plus 9d, which is equal to 25. Now equation 3, 2a plus 4d, which is equal to 30. Now in the subtrahend change all the signs, plus 2a becomes minus 2a, plus 4d becomes minus 4d, plus 30 becomes minus 30. Plus 2a minus 2a will cancel out. 9d minus 4d will give you 5d. Now 25 minus 30 is minus 5. Now 5d equals minus 5d equals minus 5 divided by 5, we get minus 1. Therefore the value of d is minus 1. Now substitute the value of d in any one of the equation to get the value of a, that is substitute d equals minus 1 in equation 1, 2 or 3. I'll substitute in equation 1, put d equals minus 1 in equation 1. Therefore equation 1 becomes a plus 2 times minus 1 equals 15. Now plus into minus minus, 2 ones are 2, a minus 2, which is equal to 15. A equals 15 minus 2, shifting to RHS, it becomes plus 2. A equals 15 plus 2, which is equal to 17. We got first term as 17. Now by using the value of a and d, we'll find out the 10th term by using the formula an equals a plus n minus 1 into d. Now a 10 equals 17 plus n minus 1 is what? 10 minus 1 into d is minus 1. We get a 10 equals 17 plus 10 minus 1 is 9 times minus 1. Now 17 plus plus into minus minus, 9 ones are 9, we get 10th term a equals 8. 17 minus 9 is 8, we get the 10th term of AP is 8. 18 equals 8. Now express it in the form of two equations, all that, find out the value of a and d. By using that, we'll find out the 10th term. Solving two equations is very important. Make any one variable with same coefficient, then you can subtract or add. Now moving to question number 5, given d equals 5, s 9 equals 75, we should find out the value of a and the 9th term. Now I'll write down the given value, d equals 5, s 9 equals 75, n becomes 9. Now a equals question mark and 9th term equals question mark. Now by using the SN formula, we'll find out the value of a. SN equals n divided by 2 times 2a plus n minus 1 into d. Now substitute the value of the given data, SN, that is 75, which is equal to n divided by 2, which becomes 9 divided by 2 times 2 as it is, n minus 1 is 9 minus 1 into 5. Now cross multiply, Now we get 75 into 2 divided by 9 in the denominator. The remaining term 2a plus 9 minus 1 is 8 times 5, which is equal to 40. Now cancelling the common term, 3 3s are, then 3 25s are. 3 times 25 is 75. Now we get 25 times 2 is 50 divided by 3. Shift plus 40 to LHS, it becomes minus 40, which is equal to 2 times A. Now by taking LCM or butterfly method, 1 times 50 is 50, 3 times 40 is 120, 50 minus 120 divided by 3, which is equal to 2 times A. Now 50 minus 120 is, we get minus 70 divided by 3, which is equal to 2 times A. Now cancelling on LHS and RHS, 2 times 1 is 2, 2 times 35 is 70, we get A equals minus 35 divided by 3. We got the first term as minus 35 divided by 3. By using this, now we'll find out the ninth term, that is by using the nth term formula, we'll find out the ninth term, an equals a plus n minus 1 into d. Now a9 equals a value is minus 35 divided by 3 plus n is 9 minus 1 into d is what? 5. Now a9 equals minus 35 divided by 3 plus 9 minus 1 is 8 times 5, which is equal to 40. Now again by taking LCM or butterfly method, we get a9 equals minus 35 into 1 is minus 35, 3 into 40 is 120 divided by 3. Now plus 120 minus 35, we get 85. 120 minus 35 is 85 divided by 3. Now we got ninth term as 85 divided by 3. The ninth term of the AP is what? 85 divided by 3. Students, hopefully you have understood these 5 problems. Based on this understanding, try to solve the remaining 5 questions in the exercise. If you get solution wrong also, no problem, you can give it a try. We'll try to solve these questions in the next videos. Until that, practice the remaining 5 questions by yourself. Thank you for watching the video. If you find my videos are useful, subscribe.